Hi everyone, I am Jason for Teach Tagdulang Poras Cabanias. A student of Western Mindanao State University, Mulave External Studies Unit, and currently taking up Bachelor of Secondary Education major in English. And for today, as one of my tasks in my core subject, the teaching profession, I am to narrate the global historical foundation of education from the ancient period up until today, which is the contemporary period. The modern sane person has no doubts about the value of education, which attaches human to the achievements of civilization and prepares him or her for the independent creative activity in the chosen field of employment. The family and university plays an important role in education because the education process appears from the family and the teaching process from the higher education institution. Education is a part of the state policy. It is budgeted with significant costs in each state. The ancient period. The school and education of the ancient East states were developed in line with specific historical, cultural, moral, and ideological values. The human was formed within the rigid social regulators, responsibilities, and personal dependence. The idea of human individuality was very poorly considered. The personality dissolved in the family, caste, and the social stratum. Hence, the reliance on strict forms and methods of education was present. The focus in teaching and education of the most ancient Eastern civilizations was on the family, church, and the state. The reason of this is that the family was not able to provide a community with sufficient number of people with experience in reading, writing, and laws. That's why the educational institutions created by a secular government and clergy began to teach them in order to supplement the roles of officials. The transition period, when the first human civilizations have arisen, is characterized by deep changes in the practice of education and teaching. The ways of transmission of the cultural heritage of ancestors from adults to children changed qualitatively. There were special education frameworks for teaching the younger generation. In this era, the preliterate history period was completed when speech and the pictographic writing as the main means of information transmission formed around the 3rd millennium BCE were partially replaced by the actual writing, cuneiform, and the hieroglyphics. The greatest influence on the development of educational thought had Confucius and his followers. Methods of teaching in his school involved teachers' conversations with students, the classification of facts, phenomena, imitation of models. At the core ideals of Confucius is the general philosophical and social education. Moral improvement is the main factors of human existence, indispensable conditions for prosperity. Confucius rests on education according to social purpose. Ideally, educated person should possess high qualities, generosity, a desire for truth, reverence, accuracy, and rich spiritual culture. The appearance and development of writing is an important factor and satellite in the genesis of the ancient East school. From pictographic writing to logography, that conveying not only the general meaning of speech, but the division into individual expression and words. The writing becomes more technically complex and requires a special training. Further development of letters associated with the emergence of the first syllable and then the phonetics. Writings lead to the simplification and facilitation of literacy teaching, which increased the productive capacities of the school. The Middle and the Medieval Period. Education in the medieval period was the prerogative of the church, especially during the early medieval period. Beginning in the late 8th century, monasteries and cathedrals started establishing schools of their own where they would educate young boys in a variety of sciences. Most of the secular education was concerned with classical Greek and Roman subjects, while a significant section of the thought syllabic comprised of religious education. Medieval education institutions were of three types: grammar schools, monastic schools, and the universities. The first university in the medieval Europe was established in Italy on 1088. The establishment of universities in Europe began in the 11th century. The primary purpose of a university was to provide advanced education to those who had already attained formal education in a monastic or grammar school. Initially, universities fell under an ecclesiastical authority such as the church, and the students as well as teachers at the universities enjoyed significant privileges. A wide range of subjects were taught at the universities, which included arithmetic, geometry, music theory, metaphysics, physics, and moral philosophies. Once a student had attained sufficient education in these subjects, he could go on to follow a specific field such as theology or law or even medicine. Typically, he then had to spend another few years in pursuing the specific literature of that field before qualifying for practice of, say, law or medicine. The Renaissance period. Education in the Renaissance centered around a rediscovery of lost ideas, leading to a rebirth of civilization. Looking back to Renaissance education provides insight into our own age as we reclaim the great texts and ideas lost over the past decades through waves of progressive educational reform. Renaissance education inherited a ready-made structure developed in the Middle Ages. The humanist ideal of rebirthing civilization by drawing upon classical antiquity was happily situated within this educational structure. Today, the classical Christian school movement has likewise drawn upon the very same structure. The liberal arts were comprised of the trivium and the quadrivium. The study of Latin and Greek were essential to the Renaissance enterprise, especially since both ancient languages were not spoken in the West. Young scholars would learn these languages in order to interact directly with the rediscovered manuscripts from the East, written predominantly in Greek. Or students would acquire Latin, the language of scholarly pursuit, so that they could read the newly available translations of Aristotle and Plato. Similarly, we can look to the past to identify educational theories, methods and practices that will enable us to rebuild and renew Western civilization. Yet, for several decades now, there has been a growing sense that educational reform is needed and, in some sectors, already occurring. And this is the growing literature in neuroscience and educational psychology. We find ourselves at the very same intersection Renaissance intellectuals found themselves. The recovery of that which was long forgotten in a context of burgeoning intellectual pursuit. We are ready for an educational renaissance. The modern or the contemporary period. The education system was more developed in urban areas as compared to rural areas. During this period, there were introduction of subjects such as arts, sciences, philosophy, and even literature. During the modern era, primary education was not much considered. During this period, the system of education was developed to take into consideration the needs and requirements of the individuals. The individuals who acquired this education were able to sustain their living in an appropriate manner. Today, the primary reason why a child is pushed into a school at the tender age of 3 years old is not that the parents want him to attain the knowledge. It is because they are afraid that their child will be left behind. Other children who are actually going through the same mindless routine. It is a common sight to see small kids carrying really heavy bags to and from school, which actually stunts their physical development. Similarly, the most prevalent psychology among students today is to fight intense competition for a certain degree to get a certain job. In this way, education has become highly commercialized and almost like a business today, with institutes charging very high fees for their degrees which promise good placements because they have tie-ups with companies. But still, they are leaving their jobs after 3 to 4 months or most of them are not satisfied. In recent times, you will notice that every educated person knows how to chat nicely with people from all over around the world. But sad to say, they have forgotten how to talk respectfully to others in their own homes, such as parents and others. Only education can help our society to progress further, and education is the only element that is equally significant for all sects, ethnicity, and social groups because it has the power to uplift everyone. Kapon kap.